Today, Dover Castle dominates the town's skyline. This is one of the mightiest fortresses in Western Europe. Never conquered, no other castle in England could match its extraordinary service in its defence against the realm.
How are we doing, folks? Right, so welcome back. This is a proper new video. I'm using a different camera today. This is a Sony A5000 camera. So we're heading up to Dover Castle. I'm with Debbie here. And I went to do Dover Castle vlogs about 4 years ago. I think I was going to say, yes, I'm going to do a series of vlogs of Dover Castle. Never did do it. Hope you enjoy it. We're just going to have a look at some bits. If you're thinking of coming to Dover Castle, take a look at this video, folks. So let's do it. War Department number 19, folks, before we head into the castle. Look at this. What was that one before?
Oh, yeah. Number 12.
Number 12. Let's go in. Journey starts here, folks. I think that's Henry VIII's, one of his battery things here. That. It's like Moat's Bulwark. It's like the one at Admiralty Pier had similar defences. It's just a cannon, there's nothing special about it. It's just a cannon. You have guns on top of it, artillery on top of it, and it's just basically looking out. Yeah, another gun position. That's mortar as well, spigot mortar. And there's a tunnel that goes through here. And there's actually rooms in here. You can't see them because the ivy's grown over it. And down there, got rooms underneath this. What's that? There's a flask down there.
Yeah.
Jesus, folks.
It looks
can't
like
even,
a big beehive, doesn't it?
It does, doesn't it? Can't even see the screen. There you are, what's that? It's a someone lost their flask down there. Comment in the comment section. Yeah. So there's the gun position there. Cannon's Gate. Late 1700s.
All the bricks at the edge, it's there.
Cool, yeah. Actually, there's a pigeon there.
They're so lucky they get to go over there.
Yeah. So I think that cat. What was the date of Cannon's Gate was built, put in like 1795, yeah, I knew that. And then you got the battlements.
Remember that time there was a lizard?
On the wall?
Yeah. See like a little hole?
Yeah, that's the tunnel that goes through into the, that goes to shoulder mount battery.
Do you think it's a clear tunnel?
I think it is, yeah. Yeah, it's got bricked up the other end though.
Yeah.
And then you've got Rokesley's Tower there, which where we're going to start the journey, folks. So let's go in to that area. Let's go. I've noticed there's dirt on this sensor actually. Better clean that. Spitfire. Hi.
Hi.
That was probably open before they upgraded it to like having a, what do you call it? A front built onto it. But I think the ones up further up have are open, if we look at them in a bit.
Yeah.
I don't know how the shaking comes out on this camera, but we give it a go, folks, shall we? Down there, always fascinate me with that thing in the grass there, that fenced off area. Fascinated me what that could have been. And I know what it is now. It's a sally port that takes you from that side to this side of the moat. And it's got no stairs in it. I don't know whether originally it would have been wooden ladders. And if the invasion come, then they got the soldiers back or pull the ladders out, then the enemy can't get in. How was ya?
Doing your thing.
Doing my thing, folks, yeah. Zoom in a bit. I like the zoom on this. 28-foot East Dry Well discovered. But where? Are they talking about the Sallyport, do you reckon? Let's go and have a look at that Sallyport.
Oh, wow. Those little steps going up to that thing.
Oh yeah.
Wow.
I forget. I remember the names of some of these towers. You got one called Rokeslee's.
Yeah, that's down
the bottom
there,
one, isn't it? The bottom one.
Yeah.
Rokeslee's Tower. There was a phone called Fubert. I'm sure there is. Something like that. So yeah, if we look, folks, if you go back, there's a video I made years ago, and we go through all the history of all the towers. Check the video out, description, or the card above. I don't even know if it actually says it on there. Oh, it says, does it say it on there? Oh yeah, Hearst Tower. You see that one down the bottom there, that Rokeslee's one, that originally looked like this? Because the Rokeslee's one has actually got brickwork and a door and a window in it.
You know, like up Whitfield, you've got Rokeslee Road, haven't you? Hurst Close, Peveril Road.
There you go, yeah. Fireplace. Like a well here or something. What's this? This ain't the dry well, is it? Don't want to drop the old keys down there, folks. What's down there? See? Well, there you are. There's another tower. Forget the name of that one as well. It's great, isn't it? Great documentary.
Very informative.
Yeah. Well, there's that well thing. A bit clearer. So that's the Sallyport. Goes down about 15 feet, 20 feet, and then it goes under this big mound and comes out the other side. From what I've heard anyway, folks. These cutouts here, these were done in late 1700s, early 1800s, around that sort of date off the top of my head, for cannons to be positioned up here, cannon fire, lowered to support the artillery. So these were lowered down, and this is the original height. How amazing is that? And I think a lot of the towers are the same. You can see again there, this one here, zoom in. See the top of that. What's the name of this one?
Say's Tower.
Say's. Do you reckon that looks deeper, doesn't it? Doesn't it? It's not as high as them. Do you reckon this has been built up? Or that's the original height?
I think it's original.
Original height?
Yeah.
Say's Tower. Up there is the old Roman lighthouse. Take a look at that in a bit, folks. I like the zoom. I love the zoom on this. It's like having a cam. It's like having a camcorder. Right, one more tower up here. Off the top of my head again. What was his name? William Twiss.
Oh yeah.
Done all the defences of the castle, sort of late 1700s, early 1800s, and he placed all the mud up against these walls to reflect any cannon or artillery fire from outside of the castle.
Yeah.
So to strengthen the walls. You see what I mean? Then all the mud's been placed up against that. So originally these were quite high, and they got parapets on the top for walkways along it, but you can't see them because they're filled up now. But all the mud is placed up against the walls there to protect it from artillery fire from the outside. How amazing is that?
Love that. That's a magic mushroom.
Oh, wow.
That is magic, isn't it? Stay away from them, folks. What's this one called? Gatton's Tower. Here we are. This one's slightly destroyed a bit, though. So. Gatons.
You hit your head in that one.
I did, didn't I? Yeah, that hurt that.
Well, you ran at it, didn't you?
Ran at it really crazy. Here we go. Sometimes I like to look out here. Over Dover. Look at Dover. Isn't it a lovely little town? Oh, watch your head though. Especially when you're getting bald. There's another one of like a defensive position on the castle there. I forget the name of that one. There's one on the other side called Horseshoe Bastion. Similar. But yeah, it sticks out. It's just no tunnels to that one. It's just a big mound. They would have put artillery on it. Facing out the sea again. Peveril's Tower. I think we're talking here, folks. I think there's a ghost story attached to this one, isn't there?
Someone buried in the wall.
Yeah.
Woman.
And sometimes
you can hear the crying and stuff like that, can't you?
Yeah.
I think you can. It's funny, it's weird that Derek Corey didn't come down here when they'd done the most haunted up here.
Look how old that central part looks. And that bit of wood above there, look. Well, old. Just, I reckon it would have been a drawbridge originally. That big slit there, I would have thought there would have been for like longbows in it.
Yeah.
Aiming down.
So, yeah, apparently you can hear the cries and the scratching on the walls, folks, from the woman that was buried alive. Was it with the dog as well?
Was it?
I'm not sure.
But what for?
Because that was it, because the tower was cursed. It kept falling down, it kept collapsing, apparently. I don't know how true the story is. It kept collapsing, so they
sacrificed
a woman. I don't know how true, that might be just a folk's tale.
Yeah.
A folk. But apparently they put the body in there and it stayed up. I don't know where I heard that story from. I can't remember. But correct me in the comment section, folks. Please do. Indeed.